Hello students, welcome to all. Today we will deal about the geography lecture, that is drainage. So first of all, the question arises that what do you mean by a drainage? Then the drainage means a kind of river, and this river, when covering a somewhat area, then that area covered by the river itself is called the drainage. Means the river system of an area is called what? Drainage. But the students, see here, there is a small tributaries also, or the small streams. When these all small streams are combined together, then they form a single main stream, and then this main stream is going to drain in an ocean or a lake or a sea. See here, then this whole system will called as drainage basin. Then how will you define a drainage basin? The definition of drainage basin is that small streams together form a main stream which ultimately drains to ocean or a lake or a sea. So students, the next important topic is water divide. What do you mean by a water divide? The definition of water divide says that an elevated area as a mountain or any upland which divides the drainage basin in two or more equal parts, or maybe even or odd the parts may be, but it divides the drainage basin. How? See here, in front of you there is a mountain which act as the water divide, which divides the drainage basin two parts. See here, drainage basin 1 and 2. So students, let's move towards the drainage system in India. So first of all, I am considering the world map from where I am extracting our the map of our motherland, that is the India. Now, within this topic, I am going to deal you the Himalayan river system. And this Himalayan river system is also called as perennial river system. But what it means that the Himalayan river system is called as perennial river system, it's just because that the Himalayan river system having a water throughout the year. Why is it so? It's just because, see here in the picture, that water or the rivers are getting the water just because of, maybe possible by the melted snow, or maybe possible by the rain. Because of that, it makes the river to have a water throughout the year, and we called it as perennial water or a river system. So next topic is the Indus river system. The river Indus rises in Mansarovar Lake, and this Mansarovar Lake is in Tibet. See here in front of you, the Mansarovar Lake is in Tibet. From here the river Indus arises and enters in the state of India, that is Jammu and Kashmir, from where it enters towards the Pakistan. It means only the 1/3 part of river Indus we are getting. Okay, see here, here it is, the river Indus, and it has its own tributaries also, just like a river Jhelum, second river Chenab, then river Ravi, then river Satluj, and one more thing is there, river Bias. But students, if you consider the whole tributaries with its main river, then this system is called the river system, means a river along with its tributaries. But students, we have to consider one thing, that this river Jhelum, river Chenab, river Ravi, river Satluj, all are going to meet the river Indus in an area called as Mithan Kot in Pakistan. And after that, a long period of time, it drains in Arabian Sea. See here. It is going to drain in Arabian Sea. So, in front of you, I am again making another tributary called as River Bias. See, here it is, the River Bias. It's all about the Indus River system. So let's move towards the Ganga River system, the important part for us. And it is also under the topic drainage system in India. To know much more about the Ganga River system, first of all, we have to consider the origin place of our river Ganga. See here it is, the river Ganga, and it is originated from a glacier known as Gangotri in Uttarakhand. And it has one more river also within this river system, a Yamuna. And River Yamuna is also originating from a glacier called as Yamunotri Glacier. And this Yamuna is going to meet the Ganga at Allahabad. Dear students, this Allahabad is the place where Sangam is originated. The Sangam is there, biggest festival, especially for the religion of Hindu, where there is a point in Allahabad, Yamuna and Ganga is going to meet. A function is there, a biggest fest, a religious fest is there called as Sangam. So let's move towards another tributaries, another rivers. The another rivers within this Ganga River system is River Ghagra, second is River Gandak, and third is River Kosi. And all these three rivers, River Ghagra, River Gandak and River Kosi, is originating from the mountains ranges of the Nepal. But this River Ghagra, River Gandak, River Kosi, having its own importance. Importance because in negative sense, it creates a flood situation, as well as it enriches the soil with much more fertility. If there is a flood, then there is a danger for the life. And if these three rivers is making the soil to be enriched, then it becomes good for us to have a good agricultural production. So students, it's all about the Ganga River system. But one more thing, what happened if Ganga is going towards the eastward sides? Then with its tributaries as well as the river Brahmaputra, the Ganga River is going to drain in Bay of Bengal. See here in front of you, zoom out the Indian state named as West Bengal, so that I should show you a delta which is going to be formed by the Brahmaputra, the Ganga and its tributaries. See here, the Ganga and the Brahmaputra flows towards the Bay of Bengal and formed a delta well known as Sundarban Delta. See in front of you the beauty of Sundarban Delta. Here it is, a tiger, and that tiger having a name, Royal Bengal Tiger. And the Sundarban Delta having its name derived from a tree, Sundari tree. So students, please keep it in your mind for your exam point of view. Have a nice day.